So you guys are gonna say to yourself, "Oh my gosh, she looks like hell," and you're not gonna be wrong. I wouldn't have vlogged today, but if I'm being honest with myself, I started these vlogs to document what it's like being a 20-year-old during a global pandemic, just living my little at-risk life. And some days are not as good as others, and that's just like part of the honesty of the vlog is some days are bad, especially when you are an at-risk person and you're just stuck at home and you keep seeing like how much the world doesn't give a shit about you. Or at least your own country, am I right, America? Can't blame this on the whole world. The whole world's done pretty okay. But it just is, sometimes it is really hard on the mental health. And I know some of you may think that's like stupid, but it is, it's a problem. It's hard sometimes. So I've been crying for the past 3 days. I can't stop crying because I'm just so overwhelmed with what's going on in America politically. I'm overwhelmed with the like imminent threat of fascism that not a lot of people seem concerned about right now. And I'm overwhelmed with the amount of people, like even family members and people that know me that are still adamantly anti-wearing a mask, even though, well, they may not realize, but somewhere in the back of their mind, they know that, you know, their little cousin, their friend from school, etc., isn't working a job this summer for some reason, hasn't been on any trips this summer for some reason. And the people that really know me that aren't taking this seriously, it just breaks my heart more than anything, that are still adamantly saying that their freedoms are worth more than my own ability to go out in public, than my own livelihood. So it's really hard. It's hard on the brain. Also, it's thunderstorming, which is actually really nice. I love thunderstorms. And I was thinking about driving to mom's today to make some Chinese food and like cry, but it's thunderstorming. My truck doesn't have air conditioning, and also it needs oil, and I don't want my truck to explode on the side of the road and I will be stuck there in the heat with my windows down in a thunderstorm. It just doesn't seem like a good idea. Seth has been really nice to me. He understands when I get like this, and he knows how hard it is to be in this situation. He's had to cut back a lot on his life too, just because he wants to keep me safe, and so he understands the personal effects that it is when your whole country disregards, you know, your own personal well-being because, well, you should just stay home so the rest of us can get back to our lives. Like, getting back to my life doesn't mean jack shit. And don't you dare come to these comments with your opinions as to why wearing a mask is unconstitutional and all that bullshit, because first off, you're wrong and there are court cases that prove it, and second, I will just cuss you out. I am done. I don't give a fuck. So just don't say it because it's not gonna end well for you. And if you can't tell, I'm like almost crying. I have said very few words today. You know how when you're like cry and you talk, it just makes you cry? It's rough. Seth came home for lunch and made me a salad because I was just like in such a bad way. You know, you ever be so like morbidly depressed that you can't get up? Maybe you don't, and I'm gonna be called a snowflake for this, but mental health is real, you guys, and it's a real bitch. And it's something that needs to be taken seriously. Not to say that, you know, all of the regulations for the world need to be lifted because mental health is more important than physical health. It's just that we need to be considerate of each other so that, you know, us at-risk people aren't at home wondering, you know, if we were to kill ourselves, would people just not notice or would they be a bit happier? That's a rough thought. Anyway, so I'm making fries. A shameful amount of fries to have for one person for dinner, but I'm sad and I like to eat double my weight in potatoes. So I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna crochet a bit. Today's gonna be really low key because fuck this shit. You know what I mean? The storm is really pretty though. You wanna go look for a second? But check out that storm. I love the rain. It's very understanding. I could ramble about all my mental health things. I need to go back to therapy. You know what? My therapist called me. I don't know, this is probably sharing too much, but I was in therapy for like a year because of a whole sexual assault debacle from me being in high school and also my grandma dying, and things were really bad. So I was in therapy for like a year, and then I decided a couple of months ago that I didn't need to go anymore. And I was doing better. And then the world shut down. So I got a call from my therapist the other day and she's like, "Hey, are you dead? I'd just like to know what's going on." I haven't called her back. I might email her and maybe set up like a phone appointment. I don't know. There's so much like shame around mental health. And you know what, I'm probably also gonna get comments saying I'm just rambling, and you know what, I am just rambling. So if you don't wanna watch it, go watch somebody else be sad. I'm doing this more for me than for you, to be completely honest. But there is such a stigma around getting help for your mental health and like mental health in general. If you have any problems at all, you're probably like weak or crazy. And I know that like I am at risk for like career backlash just for talking about my own mental health and even like my own sexual assault experience because frankly, I don't know why. Just because of how our society is, I guess, and it's ridiculous. Therapy should be as common as, like, going to the doctor. Frankly, it's way better than doctor's visits because therapists at least listen to what you're saying most of the time instead of doctors who are like, oh, you're probably just making that up. You're a girl, right? So it's probably just all in your head because, you know, doctors like to do that. I should talk about my experience in the American healthcare system more because being a frequent flyer sick person, you know, you have a lot of stories and I have a lot of miles on my card, you know what I'm saying? And so I'm sorry I look like a crazy person and I'm sorry we're talking about some weird shit today, but I just, fuck. The world so much and I'm so mad. I'm just waiting for my french fries to be done, so I'm gonna go eat them and we'll see how it goes.